Hello, everybody. I hope you're all doing well. Today I'm going to show you two math exercises. One is going to be with the numbers 1 to 10, which are so important, and the repetition of these exercises is so important for your child to be able to internalize the numbers and have the one-to-one counting. And you want to, again, make sure, just like Mrs. Anderson has said and Miss Echo has said, with this kind of an exercise, that your child needs to pretty much know the numbers 1 to 10. And this is a variation of those exercises that Miss Echo and Mrs. Anderson have already shown you or talked about. And I'm going to need a basket of, you could have shells or beans or beads or stones or pasta. And I made some little number cards that are, these are just made from construction paper. This particular one is 5 inches long and 2 inches wide, and you fold it in half and inside write one of the numbers from 1 to 10, including 0, which is so important and actually so much fun. This particular exercise with shells has 10 different kinds of shells in it, so this is especially a variation. I'm going to take the shells out. Fragile, so I want to be careful. I love these shells. They're so beautiful. This exercise is especially fun if you do it at a distance, and that helps your child to be able to work on the memory of numbers, holding the number in their mind while they go to another area to find the shells. So we would leave these shells on this rug and take the numbers to a different rug, and then have the basket there as well, and your child will choose a number and then bring the amount. But before I can begin my work, I have some sorting work to do. So I'm going to choose a kind of a shell, and you could talk about the names, but for this exercise, because I want to isolate the idea of counting, I'm not going to name them. But later on you might want to look up the names of the shells, and you could have your older children help you with that. And they could even write a label that would name each of the kinds of shells. I better turn these right side up. Some of my shells are hiding. Ah, that's similar, but not the same. Whoops. I'm going to turn these right side up. I think that will help me to identify which ones are the same, which ones are different. This helps me to make judgments and comparisons. If this exercise were in the sensorial area, your child could have a blindfold on and just feel which shells are the same, because each one feels so different. This is a match. Okay, I think I have all of these, so I think I will gather all of the ones that look like this. And if your child is having trouble finding it, you might just take one as an example until you find the one that matches. Okay, I think I have all of these. And I'll try this one. Hmm. Oops. Better be careful with how I pick these up. And I'm not counting the shells right now, I'm just sorting. That one was hiding. And then all of these are alike. Okay, now I'm ready to take a number. Open it up. And I can do this secretly, or I can let you know. That says five. I'll show you. Five. I'm going to turn it upside down just so I really can't see it, so I keep that number five in my mind. One, two, three, four, five, six. Too many. One, two, three, four, not enough. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. And I'm going to move these out of the way. And then I can check my number, and it says five. So your child would continue on with the game, choosing a number and then finding the set of shells that matches. It's a lot of fun, and it's especially a lot of fun if it's done at a distance. Hello again. For this exercise, you will need some shells, 100 shells, or you could use buttons or acorns or seeds or beans or beads. They should all be similar in size and kind. So I'm going to lay out some shells to have 100. So I'll do 10 sets of 10. And I already have made, and you will want to make some thin green arrows to mark the units from 1 to 9, some thicker blue arrows to mark the tens from 10 to 90, and one arrow that's red and the thickest one for 100. And I'm going to start counting the shells for the first set of 10. One, two, three, eight, nine, And I'm going to put a little, just a little space between this first set of 10 and the next set of 10. And you'll continue counting until you have 10 sets of 10. So, now the shells are laid out in 10 sets of 10, and I can begin to count. So, 1, 2, 3. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay. Now, for the rest of these sets of 10, I will count every shell, but I'm only going to mark the end of the sets. So 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Twenty-one, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. And you'll continue counting until you get to 100. So, I've counted all the way to 100. And then you could ask your child to read the labels to you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. And then that gets your child ready for skip counting. When you feel like they've worked with this several times, then you might have them turn around and see if they could count by tens without looking. And when you're all finished, then they can clean up the work, put all of the arrows back into their box, and all of the shells back in the dish. Either fold or roll up your mat and take your board and all the other pieces of the activity to the designated spot so they could practice over and over again.